you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans. This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Shawnee High School for today's girls lacrosse game between the Cherokee Chiefs and the Shawnee Renegades. I'm Jimmy Freezer along with Scott Glossner. Scott, what can we expect from today's game?
Well, Jimmy, this is a very uncharacteristic game between two district schools. Cherokee, the one that's undefeated. Shawnee, the one that's winless. I don't know what to expect. I do know this. Shawnee, no matter what their record, is always very tough to beat at home. So I look for a great game here today on LDTV.
All right. Thank you, Scott. We'll be back for the draw. Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward. Please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmelagrana@lrhsd.org.
We don't have a picture.
Yeah, we're not getting anything right now. Can you hear better?
I can hear now.
Better?
Yes.
Yours too loud, Jimmy, or what?
Yeah, mine's good.
We can hear you now, but we have no picture on our monitor.
Yeah.
All right, working on it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here. Yeah. Huh?
We don't need a picture. We're pros.
Yeah. All right, 3, 2, 1. And we are back here, ladies and gentlemen, for today's lacrosse game. Girls lacrosse, as Scott said before, it's going to be a real close game today. Well, that's what we're hoping out of district schools. Cherokee Chiefs are coming in 3-0, and the Shawnee Renegades coming in 0-3. Interesting fact to look at, before the season, Julie McGrory, the coach for the Shawnee Renegades, was 20-2, and she has now lost as many games this season as she has in her two-year tenure at Shawnee High School. It's now time to take a look at the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident at 732-452-7275. Let's send it over to Bonnie Brager with the report.
Thanks, guys.
I got the chance to speak with both Shawnee's coach McGrory and Cherokee's coach Niederberger before today's game. And Coach McGrory wants her girls to play confidently and smart and be together today. Coach Niederberger wants them to approach the game just as they always do, and to keep the energy high and keep themselves mentally ready for anything. Both teams want to have the best leadership as possible, and the seniors always do a great job of doing that. We should be in for a great game. Thanks, guys.
All right, thank you, Bonnie. So we were back here at Shawnee High School.
You know, I got to give credit to Bonnie and to all of our sideline reporters, and a quick thank you to the coaches who give her some time before the game. So thank you to coaches. Thanks to Bonnie.
All right, and we will be back here for the face-off here at Shawnee High School in a few.
Here, and I'm here with my son Kevin and his Uncle Ron, who's going to talk to us about drugs. Thank you for coming, Uncle Ron.
Okay.
Anytime you're ready, Uncle Ron.
So, Kev, do you got any drugs?
Ron, what the heck was that?
I mean, you said I asked him about drugs.
Don't be a patsy. Learn a better way from the partnership and our community partners.
Back here at Shawnee High School. Pretty much about 5 minutes away from game time here, Scott.
Yeah, coaches and officials and captains meeting at midfield, getting over the last bit of ground rules, each team getting their last bit of warm-ups in, and it's a big one for Shawnee, Jimmy. They don't want to fall down to 0-4. You don't ever want to lose to a district school, but to fall down to 0-4, and I happen to know that they've got two real tough games coming up against Mountain Lakes and Moorestown,
right,
who perennial state powers. If they don't find a way to get this victory, it could be an 0-6 start, which is unheard of.
Yeah,
in Shawnee lacrosse annals.
It's time now for the Equitable Keys to the Game, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident at 732-452-7275. All right, Scott, as we take a look at the keys to the game, Cherokee wants to win 50-50 ground balls.
Yeah, in other words, when the ball's loose on the turf, they want to be the ones to get the majority of those loose balls, because that gets possession. Of course, possession's how you score goals.
Shawnee on both sides wants to play smart and stay composed.
Yeah, you know, Shawnee, this is uncharted territory, 0-3. If they fall behind or anything, they have to stay composed. They can't let this game get out of hand.
And both teams want to limit turnovers.
That's in every sport we talk about, Jimmy, when we do here on LDTV. If you give the ball away, the other team's going to have way more scoring opportunities.
All right, thank you, Scott, and thank you, AXA Equitable, for the keys to the game. Shawnee going to be suffering the loss of their captain, out with an injury for an off-season injury. That is Kate McLaughlin, not going to be playing today.
That's a big loss.
It is.
You know, it's not only a quality talent loss, but it's a leadership loss, too.
Being one of the captains also.
Right, that's what I mean. And, you know, that affects the team. But on the other side of that coin, it gives somebody else the opportunity to step up, and we'll see if that happens. They've lost a couple of close contests. And right now, you know, when you lose a couple of close contests, you start to question yourself. This is a team that in the past has never had any doubts about their abilities. And they shouldn't now. They're still a very, very talented team, and I look for that to come out today.
All right. Taking a look at the goalies today. For Cherokee, we're going to see Gabby Krug, number 10. And Ashley Vernon is going to be in net for the Renegades. Shawnee losing an all-star in Bianca Smith last year. She's playing now at Boston University.
And there's Jeff Niederberger, head coach of the Cherokee Chiefs, his first season as head coach. Team record is 7-13, but as his first year at head coach, he's never lost a game, Jimmy. They're
3-0.
I don't think he'll go through his whole coaching career undefeated, but he's off to the best start you could possibly be off to.
Yeah, absolutely. See what he can do with his girls. Both teams pretty much finishing up practice soon. Should be getting into their huddles.
You know, and sometimes a point I wanted to make too. Sometimes when visiting teams come in here, they're at a disadvantage because a lot of them don't play. For instance, Lenape and Seneca, they play on the grass fields.
Right.
Cherokee doesn't have that disadvantage because the majority, maybe all of their games are probably on the turf at Cherokee. So it's not anything different for them.
We see Julie McGrory for the Shawnee Renegades. As I said before, Shawnee, her 2016 record, or her years, her record prior to this season was 20-2. And that's a pretty great record.
What a way to start off your first year as coach. You 100%. Go 20-2 and win the sectional title last year. They did lose, some key players through graduation. Of course, you spoke about Kate McLaughlin, the injury today. And you made the point that they've already lost more games right now than they lost all last year.
Right.
But Coach McGrory is very, very good at bringing the team together and not letting, things get away from them. And I think you'll see a different Shawnee team here this afternoon, quite frankly.
All right. Both teams lined up. Referees checking their sticks. Now, Scott, what if they do find something? Tossed and you have to play with another one?
I would think you'd have to get another stick,
Are there any repercussions after that, I guess?
Not that I'm aware of. It's not like in hockey in the years gone past where you had an illegal stick, it was a 2-minute penalty. I do not believe there is a different penalty for that. But it's very interesting. She takes the stick, looks at it, makes sure all the webbing is intact, and then puts the ball in there to make sure it, I'm guessing there's a certain depth it has to be.
I guess more depth would help the ball stay in.
Sure, absolutely, absolutely.
Which helps the gentlemen when their heads are...
Yeah, and for those of you that caught our game, well, first thing I'd like to say is what a much nicer day it is now for this telecast than it was last Friday.
Absolutely, Scott.
Where we could have been bundled up in parkas. And at one point, Jimmy and I thought about building a little fire in the stands at Cherokee, but they wouldn't let us. As Mr. Dodd goes by, the wonderful athletic director from Shawnee High School, looking dapper as always in his cool shades. But it was freezing.
Yes.
We don't have that factor. And I think that had a little bit of a factor in the game. It was windy, blustery, cold. And it was a great game, though. But, I look for the same today. It's a rematch of boys, this time instead of girls, instead of boys. So it'll be a lot different. You won't see the physicality that we saw. That's just not allowed in the girls' game. But they'll tell you, it's still a tough sport to play. I would never want to be a lacrosse goalie.
Oh, yeah.
They wear no pads.
Yeah.
And then that ball, it comes at incredible speeds.
Absolutely.
And have you ever fooled around with a lacrosse ball?
It's not like
a sponge ball,
no.
Okay? It's like a street hockey ball.
Yep.
It's, and today it's a little warmer, so it won't hurt as much. But, man, I'll tell you, we were playing street hockey when I was young, and you get hit in the shins with that no pads and that ball. Oh, boy. So they face the same thing today. So I give kudos to anybody that plays lacrosse. It's the second toughest sport that I think there is, and I think the toughest is, without question, golf.
Really?
Absolutely.
Oh, toughest, yeah.
Got to be a man to play golf.
Yeah, right.
Or a woman.
There you go. As we see Cherokee, they're going to be in their road oranges. Shawnee going to be in their brand new all white.
I see that with the Carolina, what do they call that?
Carolina blue.
Is it Carolina blue?
Yeah. Powder, whatever you prefer.
I called it that the other day at the Burlington County Open Golf Tournament. Coach Kessler corrected me, and Columbia Blue is what he said.
Oh, Columbia Blue. He does like that.
And I'm guessing that he's not a Duke. He's not a UNC fan.
No.
Because if you're a UNC fan, it's Carolina Blue,
right.
Obviously. But it is a nice color combination. The, mm-hmm. What I'll call the light blue, and the white and the dark blue. And you see them in a basketball game in their jerseys. It's just tradition, and that's what Cherokee is. The orange will have the white numbers, but. Cherokee orange and brown, the red and gray of Lenape, and the forest green and Vegas gold of Seneca. The colors represent the schools very well.
So Cherokee breaks their huddle, ready to go. See if Shawnee could pull off the upset. And have Coach Niederberger face his first loss of the year.
Well, that's certainly the game plan from the Renegades' perspective, and from the Chiefs' perspective, it's continue the run for the coach.
There's a little added, intensity when you're facing an undefeated team.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
You want to make them.
You want to be the one.
Make them suffer, pretty much.
You want to be the one that's the one in 3-1.
Right.
So. And Cherokee on the other side of the coin doesn't want to be the one in Shawnee's 1-3.
Right.
So. But you, as I said in the opening, throw the Wickeds out the window. This is just
good
old-fashioned Shawnee-Cherokee rivalry that's been around since Cherokee was born in the fall of 1975. So.
Oh, there you go. You did say you were the first graduating class.
Yes, I was. Moved over from Lenape as a freshman and then opened up Cherokee in September of 1975.
There you go.
All that means, Jimmy, is that I'm really old.
Not in our book.
Ah, you're a sweetheart. I can remember when Shawnee was first built. I had an older brother.
When was that?
It opened in the fall of 71, I believe.
Oh, nice.
And
we'll fact check
the school, I think.
Okay.
The year before, if I recall, they actually had split sessions.
Did they?
The Lenape kids went in the morning, and the Shawnee kids came in the afternoon, or later in the morning through the afternoon, much like we did.
Right.
As a freshman at Lenape, we people that lived in Eastham that went to Cherokee actually came in at 10.
Really?
And went to school till 4.
Wow.
Because the school was so crowded, and that's one of the reasons why Cherokee was built, and of course one of the reasons why Shawnee was built.
Well,
and of course, with the addition of Seneca down the road, it eliminated what we called the pods, you know, the outdoor classrooms. That's before your time. Maybe when you were little, you might have been out here and you saw the outdoor, trailers.
Right.
I would call them outdoor classrooms. You weren't really outdoors. But we're about ready to get started with the opening draw. And for the play-by-play of today's game, we pass it over to Jimmy Freeze.
All right. So we see Carly Clapperton for Shawnee. Can't get a good look at the Cherokee player for the draw. A little different than boys. We can talk about that during the day as they start with their sticks in the air at about waist level.
That was number 11. And I didn't know if we had an 11 on my roster.
That looked to be number 11. That was Maggie Hamilton.
Maggie Hamilton, okay. They're going to try it again.
It's going to be Carly Clapperton and Jillian Westerby. So there you go. Off to a great start here at Shawnee High School. Ball in the air.
And I'm wondering, Jimmy, if Carly Clapperton is the daughter of possibly Cherokee girls soccer coach Andy Clapperton.
Not
sure.
The
only Clapperton I know.
All right, so we see Shawnee in transition. That's Erica Barr with the ball. Comes to a stop and passes it over to Grace Kyra.
And confirmed from the truck, that is Andy Clapperton's daughter. And for those of you who don't know, Mr. Clapperton, longtime health and phys ed teacher at Seneca and the girls soccer head coach.
Yeah, that was Jenna Masiska looking for the shot. Picked up by number 64, Emma Luling.
Good ball possession right here in the first opening minutes of this game by the Renegades.
And that's
results
a shot
in a goal.
Score! That's Emma Luling for the first goal of the day. Early on the board here for the Shawnee Renegades. Number 64, Emma Luling, the senior, with the first goal of the day for the Shawnee Renegades.
Now, here's the first thing I noticed, Jimmy. They play halves in girls.
They do.
Yeah.
25.
Right. Whereas the other day in boys, they play quarters.
Right.
So.
Interesting to see the referee do the draw.
And it's actually a longer game for the girls.
Yeah.
Boys are 12-minute quarters, 48
times four,
minutes
48, 50.
Versus 50. And we'll try the draw again. Seem to have some draw malfunctions here.
Yeah. So Jillian Westerby and looks to be Carly Clapperton. Ball still on the ground. Contact from Shawnee, and that'll be Cherokee ball. Devin Fitzpatrick got hit on that, number 7. She's got the ball now. Devin Fitzpatrick comes across midfield. She'll toss it over. That's Mary Carroll.
Got almost a little weave going here by the Chiefs.
Right.
Now they set up.
Lily Fox hands it over.
It's Gabby Bodine, number 2.
Gabby Bodine has 15 goals.
Yes, she does.
In
and there's a shot. Cherokee goes wide.
Yeah. 15 goals in Cherokee's first 3 games. That's unheard of.
It's impressive.
See if she can add to that goal total today.
course, her mother works at Cherokee, Amy Bodine. Father Ray Bodine retired from Cherokee after many years of service in the district.
Well, across, and she scores. That looks like Tori Hampton, number 23, and it is. Tori Hampton scores the first of Cherokee's goals. Evens the score at one. Tori Hampton, the senior from Cherokee, number 23, scores the goal for the Chiefs. 1-1 early here at Shawnee High School. So early goal scored here by Shawnee. Emma Luling, the senior for Shawnee, and the junior for Cherokee, number 23, Tori Hampton.
Nice draw win by the Renegades.
It's Erica Barr coming across. Barr goes to the side to Clapperton. Clapperton's weaving her way around. Shoots off of the leg of Krug. Beckler goes over to Kyra. That's Luling, the goal scorer. Luling goes to Masiska. And Masiska back to Beckler. Beckler coming around. Nice play by Barr. Barr shoots.
Made a whistle before the goal.
Yes, there was. I think that might have been on Barr, too.
And I think.
Looks like Shawnee ball. And it will be. This is interesting, Scott. You know,
some sort of why penalty she just shot.
She shoots nice. Nice stop with the stick.
So the whistle stops the goal, gives her what we'll call a free shot, if you will, and the crew comes up huge. Turnaround right there would have been 2-1 for the Renegades, but now we're tied at one on a big, huge save by the goalkeeper.
And Fitzpatrick gives it to Hampton. Hampton's coming across. She's got some speed. Hampton goes to Westerby. Hampton's got it up top.
There's Bodine. Nice shifty move. No, good defense by the Renegades.
Bodine tries to go in front of the net, not going to get it. That'll roll out of
bounds. There's your turn, first turnover of the game, really.
Yep. Shawnee ball. And that's back in the stick of Vernon. Ashley Vernon in net today for the Renegades. It's the number three, Carly Clapperton. Clapperton goes to Barr. Barr to Kyra. Kyra can't corral it. It's going to roll out and Cherokee ball. Gabriella Evans closest to the ball going out. It'll be Cherokee ball. Cherokee coming across midfield. Chiotti. Gabrielle Chiotti. Behind net. Comes across in front. That's Fox, Lily Fox. Gives it to Hampton, the junior. Bodine gives it across. Hampton goes in front of the net. Shot.
What a save on
nice
Bodine.
Nice save. Yeah, that's Ashley Vernon on the save. Bodine with the shot.
Yeah, the 15 goals scored. And I'll tell you, a couple of big saves by each goalkeeper right now in these last two possessions.
Ball on the ground. Picked up by Shawnee. And back into Cherokee's possession. Nice turnover for Gab Bodine. Right in front of the net here. Not going to get the shot off. Good defense around the crease.
I think we may have a penalty. I see the flag, yellow flag in the air.
Jillian Westerby tried it.
Who's that? Yep.
Westerby shoots, scores! Top right corner. Huh?
I don't know if we have a goal or not.
Not so much. Referee says no.
Should we get another try?
Shoot. Oh, no, there you go. So, Scott, we saw on both ends. Girls thought they had a goal, but it got called back, and the goalies
came
stopped.
Up big on
yeah.
both of them, yep.
Nice job by Krug and Vernon. So, coming across, that's Grace Kyra. That's to number 22, Molly Beckler. Beckler will stop at about the 23-yard line. Behind the net is Clapperton. Coming across, shoots, scores! Oh. Number 21, Lauren Jobes. Lauren Jobes with the second goal for Shawnee. Nice play from around the net, a little wraparound action. Got the shot she wanted and made it. So in the faceoff now for Shawnee is Jenna Masiska. So I'm guessing the ball is put in between their sticks. Yes.
Yeah, their sticks are what I'll call face to face. You know, front to front.
So they just try to hit it and get it in
and
the
then,
air.
Well, it's more of a fling, I think it looks like.
That's Erica Barr. She's coming across. Doesn't look like she wants to stop. Ball gets hit out of her
stick. Oh, and that looks like a slash.
Face mask actually got hit off.
Yeah, don't know if that'll be a penalty or not, but it looked like a slash. We get another. There must be a term for this, and I'm sorry to our viewers for not knowing what the name of it is, but. They have everybody out of the way, but then yeah. as soon as the whistle blows, she gets the first step, and then they can converge on her.
She can do whatever she wants. She's not, doesn't have to directly go toward the net, as you saw. She backed up and made a play out of
she's
it.
She's actually cut off nice. There's a low shot.
Yeah, Masiska with that shot.
And there's another one in
the
score.
Oh, behind the nice shot, score by Carly Clapperton. Wow, good play out of Carly Clapperton, right in front of the net. Looked like some kind of backhand something there, Scott.
That was a nifty, nifty
move. Yes, it was.
Change of the stick from the forehand to what we will call the backhand. And resulting in the goal.
Yeah, Carly Clapperton makes it 3-1. For Shawnee. Ball picked up. That's Fitzpatrick. Oh, ball falls out on the ground. 50-50 ground. Ball picked up by Shawnee. Nice play. And she's pushed to the ground. So that it'll be a Shawnee ball. That's Carly Clapperton. Nice job out of her in this first 9 minutes of play. There's Molly Beckler. Beckler goes to Kyra. Kyra scores. That's Emma Luling. Emma Luling gets her second.
Wouldn't shock me if we see a Cherokee timeout here.
Emma Luling, number 64, the senior for Shawnee, makes the score 4-1. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
There's the nice pass right there to, and really quick release.
Yep. Give and go right there, right into the net. Now Luling makes it 4-1.
Yeah, Luling with a real quick release. She got it and got rid of it before the defender ever had a chance to get into the shooting lane.
All got started from that Carly Clapperton ground ball pickup. It was actually in the air. Air ball, if you want to call it that. But she got it and started the push. Cherokee ball after this whistle. Right in front of the net here. Good opportunity. Shoot. Scores.
Gabby Bodine.
It is Gabby Bodine. Number two. Make that 16 on the year.
Nice answer by the Chiefs. They had fallen behind. Shawnee had scored the last three, and a real nice answer by the Chiefs offense there. Went to the person that scores the most goals, and she delivered. So now it's 4-2.
It's like passing to Sidney Crosby. Got a good chance of it going in.
I'll prefer Connor McDavid.
Oh, don't tell me you're an Oilers fan.
No, I'm just not a Penguins fan.
Well, true. I would respect that.
You can't pick a flyer. They don't score
like
that. Yeah,
I'd love to say Wayne Simmonds, but. Regardless, here we have the ball in midfield. Nice play.
That time Gabby Bodine took the draw in a very different manner. They weren't, you know, face to face. They were kind of at the side of each other.
So that's Bodine back with the ball. Cutting the Shawnee lead in half. Behind the net. Looks like Mary Carroll.
Trying to make a move.
Carroll goes in for a nice
save.
Step. Yeah. Good save from Ashley Vernon. There's Molly Beckler. Coming across midfield to Grace Kyra. Grace Kyra. Wow. That's a check right there, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why they stopped it and said Shawnee ball. I don't think that's legal. But not a penalty. I wonder what you have to do to get a penalty.
Oof. Grace Kyra. Oh, and another whistle. Kyra outside the blue circle. Kyra comes in, shoots, and didn't get everything she wanted on that shot. Saved by Krug. It's Fitzpatrick. Nice turnover. Here comes Shawnee. 3-on-3 right now. Erica Barr. Stops and holds.
Nice job by Erica Barr there. She realized that they were, you know, defended well, and so she pulls it back out and will set up a set offensive play for the Renegades. It's good heads up, because if you try to force something there, you're liable to create it. You give away the ball, you know, a turnover, and let Cherokee come back the other way. So now the Renegades will set up their offense.
Well, it's been working so far, Scott. Grace Kyra on the far side. Gives it to Barr. Kyra goes to Beckler. Beckler going to come across the net. Beckler trying to go in front. Beckler shoots. She scores.
Very solid individual play there by Molly Beckler.
Yep. Wrapped around. Got the ball on the other side, on the right side of the net, if we're looking at it. Wrapped around. And shoots and scores. Finds the opening. Making it 5-2, Shawnee. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
You see Beckler going behind the net. Now she comes out.
Yeah, the defender.
Finds the gap. Yeah,
that was Fitzpatrick. Yep. Devin Fitzpatrick turned around looking toward the goalie.
Yep, found the gap there and sliced right through it, and a good solid shot.
Ball in the air. Nice play by Gab Bodine. Got the ball in the air and caught it on the run. And ball on the ground here. 50-50 ball picked up by Shawnee.
Now, I am not in any way, shape, or form a lacrosse expert, but to me it doesn't make sense why they have to stop that play if Shawnee still has the ball.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Like, it doesn't affect the game.
Right.
Yeah.
I could see if the turnover, if it created a turnover and it went to Cherokee, but I just don't understand why that had to be stopped.
Kind of helps Cherokee.
It does.
Catch up and catch the breath.
Yes, I agree 100%. Again, I'm not a lacrosse aficionado in any way, shape, or form. I'm not saying anything bad about the officiating. It just doesn't make sense why you'd stop that when possession did not change. It didn't affect possession. I mean, she didn't knock her down or anything.
Right. Well, regardless,
Shawnee still has the ball.
Yes. And that's Grace Cairo on the near side.
But my point is, it kind of disrupts the flow of the game, too.
Yeah.
Oh, nice move. Oh, yeah. Oh. And she got hit up high.
Beckler still got the ball,
how
though.
How about that? Boy, she's one tough player. She wants to know there's no call. I guess got whacked in the face. I can barely see. Noticing some of the Shawnee students here coming up with what looks like hamburgers and hot dogs.
Yeah.
They got the grill
would
going
like
today
to know,
and everything.
Would you like to know how that goes?
How's that go,
as
Jim?
As we see a shoot saved by Krug. Every time the boys track team wins a meet, Mr. Soriano, a.k.a. Bull, treats them all to a grill out. And all the kids have to bring in the foods, the frozen hot dogs. I threw discus freshman and sophomore year. No big deal.
Did you get many hot dogs and hamburgers?
Oh, absolutely. Can you not tell, Scott? I mean, honestly. Here.
You're a specimen. Let's face it, Jimmy. Yeah, Jimmy, so if I might be a golf aficionado, would you consider yourself a grill guy, a aficionado on burgers and dogs?
Okay. I learned that all from my father.
Okay.
I'm a medium rare type of guy. Back to action here. Cherokee with the ball. We have fun here on LDTV Sports.
And I'm assuming the hot dogs and hamburgers are after practice, not before.
Yes.
Okay, good.
Sometimes if Bull's in a good mood, Mr. Soriano, we won't even have practice at all and just have the grill out.
Huh.
So, depends on his mood. You know, we could win, and if he's not in a good mood, no barbecue. It's all him. But Mary Carroll has the ball behind the net. Coming across, trying to get by. Good defense by Shawnee.
Tried to get inside to Bodine, but she was, I'm going to say, triple team. There were three Shawnee girls right around her. And we've got another whistle. And this time, possession will stay with the Chiefs.
Yes, Shawnee.
No, Shawnee.
That's Molly Beckler. She's been everywhere today in the first 15. So you really can't check here much.
No.
In girls lacrosse.
No.
There's Grace Kyra coming across at the 20-yard line. Kyra's definitely looking for Luling. Probably Kyra coming across. Sticks hit. Cherokee ball.
She almost was looking to kind of do the same thing Molly Beckler did on her goal.
Right, wrap around and find the opening. Gabriella Evans comes across the Shawnee S. Kylie Evans, most likely sisters. We'll guess they are. Cherokee ball behind the net.
And now back out to the top.
Tori Hampton has a goal today. Cherokee working around. Shoots a nice stop by Vernon. So that timeout really never happened, Scott, going back to that.
No, it didn't. I'm surprised when I got the three straight goals. They've swapped goals since then. Cherokee very patient, I'm noticing, here on offense on this possession. You know, despite trailing by three goals, they're not getting out of their set game plan that they put forth. Oh, just out of the reach.
Yep.
I think that was Westerby.
So Coach Niederberger definitely showing faith in his team by not calling the timeout and letting them play. You know, it's only 5-2. It's only three goals. You can get back quickly.
Oh,
and there's
one of them right there. Nice
it is
shot.
Right there as we were talking about it. We're going to have to find out who that was exactly. I'm thinking that was Mary Carroll.
I believe you are correct.
Number 30, Mary Carroll, not just her first of the day for the Cherokee Chiefs. Well, there you have it. And that's 5-3 now with 8:08 remaining here at Shawnee High School in the first half. Good play in front of the net by Mary Carroll. Mary Carroll, she should have, I'm pretty sure she has seven this year.
Draw at midfield.
Yeah, Mary Carroll gets her eighth of the year. Tori Hampton's got it, and she's on the run. Erica Barr keeping pace. Hampton right in front of the net, shoots, scores!
Amy Bodine.
There she is.
Fine two-on-one developed there. Hampton with a nice penetration on the right side. Looked center to Bodine, who got in behind the defender, and now we're back to a one-goal game.
Gabby Bodine scores.
And I think now we have a Shawnee timeout.
Cherokee scores two in the span of 20 seconds. 12 seconds. Hey. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
There's Hampton penetrating, draws both defenders, which leaves Bodine with a step on the inside, and she's a goal scorer. She's not going to miss that one.
Score now 5-4. Getting good here in Shawnee High School. At Shawnee High School. Taking a look at the goal scorers so far. Gab Bodine notches her second. Tori Hampton's got one. And Mary Carroll's got one. Those are for Cherokee and for Shawnee. Carly Clapperton's got one. Lauren Jobes, Molly Beckler, and Emma Luling has two. Looking for her hat trick. See if she can get there. In our last 8 minutes of the first half.
So if you're Coach McGrory here, you just want to tell your girls, hey, look, you still got the lead. We've played a really solid game here, first 17 minutes of this half. Let's continue to attack. Let's continue to do the things that got us our, you know, three-goal lead back. But since the Chiefs have put Amy Bodine in there to take the draws after goals, she has not lost one yet. So that's been the change that, yeah, oh, Gabby Bodine. What did I say, Amy?
Yeah.
Well, her mom's
out there.
Is that
her mom?
Yeah, that's her mom.
She appreciates it.
Well, she's a little older than 19, so that probably would violate the NJSI rules.
Probably, what, 29?
Maybe tops.
I gotcha. Yeah.
But in all seriousness, since Gabby went in there to do the draws, they haven't lost one yet.
Yeah,
and we'll see what happens now. And it's a whole different style. You notice in the first couple of draws,
ball up in the air, picked up by Shaw.
Eventually, nobody.
Oh, still on the ground, and there's Devin Fitzpatrick to get the ball. Fitzpatrick on the run to Hampton. Hampton's got some speed. Moves around her defender. Hampton comes across, ball on the ground, picked up. That looks like Jenna Masiska.
It was almost the same type play they just ran for the goal. It was Gabby Bodine, but she was. The defender stayed right on her this time.
Carly Clapperton pressured. Gives it to Kira Lundberg. It's number 17, Aaron Wicker. Up top, Kelsey Martin with the ball.
She's trying to ratchet up that defense now.
Kelsey Martin still has the ball. Gives it to Clapperton. Lauren Jobes gives it over to Masiska to Barr. Over to Molly Beckler.
No rush here for the Renegades.
Clapperton around the net. Lauren Jobes gives it to Masiska. To Barr. Barr, nice move. Barr shot, score, top shelf. Get those cookies, Erica. Wow, nice play from Erica Barr for her first goal.
Great one-on-one play there.
Yeah, all started from that move. Lost her defender. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Here's the move right here at the top of the key. Nice little juke back to the inside and then gets the opening and goes high. Great shot. Great individual effort there by Barr.
Erica Barr, the junior, gets her first of the day. Ball picked up on the run by Bodine. Hampton now. Ball behind the net. Cherokee's got it. Coach Niederberg telling him to move it around, move it around. Find that open hole. Looking at 6-4 here. Shawnee with 5 minutes approach, 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Comes across, shot. Shot scored. That looks like who? But
Gabby,
Bodine.
Yep, Gabby Bodine. That's the hat trick.
There she is. Bodine looks like she went low. Maybe looking for a five-hole kind of action, as we call in hockey.
Looks like she almost skipped it off the turf.
Yeah. Well, regardless, Gab Bodine third.
Sorry. I mean, that's another aspect of playing on the turf. The ball actually, if you've ever been to a Phillies game or anything, the ball actually, when it hits the turf, actually picks up speed. Yep. You know, you've seen, like, deep in the hole at shortstop, they'll purposely skip it off the turf just to gain, you know, to gain a little speed on the throw.
Score 6-5 here at Shawnee High School.
Another loose ball. And they
nice. Molly Beckler. Molly Beckler on the run gives it to Masiska. Masiska's got open. She scores! Jenna Masiska with her first of the day. Scott, that all started from Molly Beckler's, you'd call it a 50-50 ball. Picks it up on the run right to Masiska. Masiska's got the shot. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Nice pass on the wing. Masiska coming right on in. A real solid shot. Again, low to the far side, just inside what I will call the left post. So it's interesting. Cherokee crawls back to within one on two different occasions, and Shawnee answers almost immediately to increase the lead back to two.
Ball in the air.
And it's going to be awarded to Shawnee.
Molly Beckler coming across.
Oh, that's a block. Yeah, yep. I was going to say. Almost looked like a basketball block there.
Yeah,
you know
same
what I mean?
Kind of
yep.
Same call. Yep. Yeah.
Are they in 1-1 yet? Oh, I'm sorry. One.
Grace Kyra. Oh, nice play by Grace Kyra.
Nice
a little
spin move.
Kyra's still in possession.
And now pulls it back out and sets up the offense. Be a big goal here if Shawnee can get this lead back to three. You know, they've seen the Chiefs cut that deficit on two occasions to one, and they've answered.
Right.
So it'd be nice if, from their perspective, hey, let's get this right back to where it was, and no ground lost. But a loose ball, and there's a turnover.
Yeah, Tori Hampton, here she comes.
She can motor.
Nice play on Masiska. The ball falls out, though.
But they're going to get Masiska, I believe, for some sort of foul.
Sure. Coming across, that looks like Mary Carroll. Carroll with the move, looking
for
Hampton.
Defense.
Yeah, good defense.
Cherokee will keep possession, but that was nicely defended because I'll tell you what, if that pass connects, she's got a real good scoring opportunity right in front of the cage.
Yeah, that was Aaron Wicker on the defense.
It's Bodine out at the top.
Here
dangerous.
She goes, looking for four. She shoots.
Boy.
She scores. Her fourth of the day.
You're not stopping that one.
No. On average, you can divide 15 by 3. You got 5 by 5 per game. That's pretty good.
You must be an accelerated kid.
Absolutely. That's me. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab. Replay Ivy Rehab physical therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
This is off the start here, and she'll just move in, and just unleash a wicked shot.
So that's her.
And so there's a two-goal swing right there. Yeah. Cherokee had possession. Looked like they had an opportunity. Shawnee looked like they had an opportunity to go back up by three. The turnover results in a Cherokee goal, and now it's back to one. Just over 2.5 to go in the first half.
Good action here at Shawnee High School.
And interesting, a change in the draw.
So that's Erica Barr coming across the 30-yard line. Kicks it back out. Passes over to Masiska. Not many subs here, Scott.
No, we've only seen a handful.
Yeah.
Ball loose. Oh, nice hustle there by the Chiefs, but it's going to result in Shawnee keeping it. Real good hustle there by number four, Olivia Singer. She almost got that loose ball on the ground. Shawnee able to maintain possession.
So Masiska's going to go to Molly Beckler. Coach McGrory saying they got 2 minutes, about 1:43 remaining.
You don't have to force anything here. You have the lead. You know, even if you want to, I'm not saying sit on it, but try to find that open lane. Try to find that good shooting angle. Try to convert here.
So pretty much what Shawnee's doing on offense is they're bunching up, getting the defenders confused, and bringing one girl out, trying to attract them as Grace Kyra comes across. She'll give it to Molly Beckler. Beckler's going to come in toward the net.
And then we're going to get it some sort of foul.
The referee's raising the roof over there. And it'll be Shawnee ball. No? Yep. Beckler goes, shoots, scores! Molly Beckler notches her second of the day. 1 minute and 12 seconds remaining in this first half. And Beckler makes it another two-point game. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab physical therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. Molly Beckler's got that. Shoot scores. We'll call it a penalty shot. Are we allowed to do that, Scott?
I don't think it's technically a penalty shot, but it's some sort of free ball, free play.
Free play. We'll like that. I like that. So draw, midfield. Kyra's chasing after it for Shawnee. Picked up. Fitzpatrick was also chasing after it. That's Jillian Westerby. Katie Copper.
Westerby with a nice job picking up that loose ball.
It's got some inside information about Katie Copper. She was my preschool girlfriend. Called her Katie Cupcake.
There's no end to your inside info. Well,
there isn't, Scott. Not until they tell me. Devin Fitzpatrick was... all right.
Must be a timeout.
Yeah, I guess they can't take their sticks to the huddle.
Yeah. Obviously not.
Do they have to come back to the same spot that they were?
I'm guessing they must. That's why the sticks were put where they were. Interesting. There's some interesting... One of these days, Jimmy, you and I ought to spend some time reading the rules.
We should. On a beach somewhere. How about that?
I'm down with that. But, yeah, that's interesting. They're all laying out there. And imagine if you were a stick collector and selling them on eBay, you could pick all them up and make a little fortune. Because I'm guessing that those are not inexpensive items.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Not at all. Probably just like the face mask and the cleats.
Yep. So, looking into the Cherokee huddle, they find themselves down 8-6 with 38 seconds remaining in the first half. Their 3-0 record, I wouldn't say it's in jeopardy yet, but certainly Shawnee's not looking like a team that's 0-3.
Right. They've
played very strong, both offensively and defensively. Both teams have had several real good scoring opportunities and converted, but there's been a couple of really nice saves by each goaltender on a couple of different occasions here this afternoon. So kudos to the goalies, because we could have double figures for either of those teams.
So how does Coach McGrory keep the Shawnee girls level-headed and, sure that they stay calm, even though they are beating the undefeated team?
Keep doing what you're doing. So far you've played pretty much a flawless game, a couple of turnovers, the one turnover that resulted in the goal. Gabby Bodine's going to get hers. They know that.
Right.
It's the other girls that you can't let it go off, and you've got to have somebody on Gabby Bodine at all times. One of her goals was on what we'll call the free attempt. The other was a beautiful feed by Hampton. And when you give it, I think two of her goals actually were on free attempts. So three of her four goals have been really on plays that they had no chance on. Other than that, they've done a nice job of keeping her out of the middle. That's where she's most dangerous. So defensively, they're playing well. Offensively, they've moved the ball around nicely. They've been very patient. They haven't forced too much, which would result in turnovers. But they're very content to play the outside circle to set up, as you said, that when they bunch together and somebody breaks free, that's a real fine play, because who do I have? I have this guy, but all of a sudden, it's like playing that game at the Phillies game when the ball's under the hat and you have to guess which hat it's under. In this case, it's which girl's going to come out and get the pass.
Right. Back in action.
Big goal here. I think we may only see one more goal in this half,
and
if it's Cherokee to get it, it's a one-goal game at the half. If not, if they can't convert, it's a two-goal game, and that's, obviously one more goal that they're in the lead by.
So approaching 18 seconds now, Torrey Hampton's got the ball. They're definitely going to probably want to shoot and score to get this back.
There's the
right
pass.
Right through the net, she scores! That's number 6, Lily Fox.
Well designed. Now, that's a play they ran with Gabby Bodine, and in that case, Gabby Bodine stayed on the outside and kind of decoyed the Shawnee defense a little bit.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. So we should see.
Here comes Hampton.
Hampton with a nice assist. And Fox.
And there's Fox.
Yep. She goes right in with 8 seconds remaining. Cut the lead to 1.
So well done.
Yeah. The timeout was successful.
And now whoever gets possession of this, the defensive team, whoever loses possession of this has to play some solid defense. You don't want to give up that goal with 8 seconds to go, and we're going to redo. We're going to have a do-over. Third or fourth time we've had to redo the draw here this afternoon.
Ball up. Picked up.
And by the time you get it, the half's going to be over.
Yeah, that's Katie Copper.
Yep, and there it is.
And that is the end of our first half here, ladies and gentlemen, at Shawnee High School with our score 8-7 Shawnee. Gabby Bodine with an absolutely terrific first half, scoring 4 goals. And the Shawnee Renegades have 2 girls with 2 goals today. And that is Molly Beckler and Emma Luling. So good work by both teams. Cherokee had 2 goals early in the first, in 12 seconds, around 7 minute mark. So good work.
Well, Shawnee had a 4-1 lead at one point, 5-2 at one point. So in the last, they've been outscored 5-3, so.
All right, Scott, we will be back here on LDTV Sports for our second half at Shawnee High School.
Lunch and Learn is new, but it's a lot of fun and it gives a lot of opportunities for kids to do what they want with their time. I do a lot of my homework and I study a lot during Lunch and Learn, and I can also socialize with a lot of different groups of friends.
I really like it, and it seems like the students really like it too. It's nice to have a longer period to eat. That's always wonderful. But then it can also be used for other things like lab time, meeting with students for extra help, giving a test or quiz makeup, or club meetings too. So that's made it really useful.
I'm personally a fan of Lunch and Learn because during it you can have meetings with different clubs and everything. And being an athlete, it's hard to make meetings after school, so it frees up my time after school for that.
There's movement throughout the building, so they may eat in one spot and then migrate to a different area. They're getting a lot of stuff done. Some of them are just hanging out and just having some downtime in their day too, which I think our kids really need.
They don't have to be nervous about like who's in their lunch period or not having any friends like in their actual lunch, because everybody has lunch at the same time.
There's a lot less stress. There's a lot less pressure to, you know, rush through your lunch and worry about getting to your next class on time, because you know have so much more time and you can relax a lot more.
In the past, it was just such a race for students to get down to the cafeteria and actually get a meal and sit down and eat.
Sometimes you would be in line the entire time and you would get 5 minutes to eat. So this is a lot better. There's a lot more time.
I think the students really like it. They like having that break in the middle of the day to get caught up on homework, get ready for the next class, get things done. It is amazing to see how many students are actually, you know, in the media center or in the cafeteria using the time to get some work done.
It gives you that extra time that you might need with a teacher if you need to go over a lesson one more time.
Lunch and Learn has given us a lot of flexibility in what we're able to do to meet with students who want to come in and study, go over questions, problems, whatever it might be, when they might not ordinarily be able to come in before school or after school.
It's a great opportunity for students to have that one-on-one tutoring, even if it's only for 5 minutes or it's for the full 50 minutes. They're able to come in and ask for help on anything, whether it's homework or an upcoming quiz or a test.
Having lunch in the middle of the day makes me feel a lot more refreshed when I go back for the second half, and it's like the second half goes by a lot faster, I feel like, because you've had this big break right in the middle of it, so it's good.
I do feel a lot more refreshed just because I get to relax a little bit instead of just rushing from one class to the other.
It gives us more time to unwind and look at like previous classes in the day and also plan ahead for future classes that we have.
This year's schedule definitely gives us a lot more freedom. I mean, you have to kind of make the best use of your time between eating, studying, going to clubs, getting extra help, and then like just socializing with your friends. And I think it really has like made students more independent with their time.
I think Lunch and Learn does help prepare students for college, especially because college is all about time management. So it allows them to have kind of that freedom during the school day to start practicing those skills of, all right, I have an hour of my time to do anything I want. Am I going to prioritize schoolwork? Am I going to prioritize socializing? And they can start to make those decisions in a high school setting.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990. www.debora.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.p.
pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
Back here at Shawnee High School. Take a quick minute to see our goal scorers of the day. So starting with the Cherokee Chiefs, Gab Bodine has 4 goals so far. Excuse me. Lily Fox has 1. Tori Hampton's got 1. And Mary Carroll has 1. On the Shawnee side, Carly Clapperton has 1. Jenna Masiska, Erica Barr, and Lauren Jobes all have 1. And both goal scorers with 2 for Shawnee, Molly Beckler and Emma Luling, making our score 8-7. Scott, what can we expect from this second half?
Same as the first.
Yep.
Throw the records out the window.
A lot of back and forth.
Goals will come in numbers. You know, 15 goals in the first half. Shawnee needs to come out strong, though. They can't let Cherokee. You know, if they let Cherokee get on a 3 or 4 goal run, now you're in a little trouble. You're going to doubt yourself again. They're in a good spot. They have the lead at halftime.
Yeah.
So I look for Shawnee to be very tough again.
It's time now for our Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. Equitable, be life confident. At 732-452-7275, and let's send it over to Bonnie Brager with the report.
Thanks, guys. So I got the chance to talk with both coaches, and Coach McGrory wants her girls to approach the game the same way that they did in the first half as they will the second half. They want high energy and to play with a lot of heart, and Coach Niederberger would like to limit their mistakes and play with high energy. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Bonnie. Back in action here with Shawnee's ball rolling out but picked up by Molly Beckler.
Just missed that connection there to Barr, cutting down what I'll call the slot.
Molly Beckler up top. And a collision at about the 10-yard line. Both girls up.
We're having a little discussion here. Make sure that the Shawnee girls at
Shawnee coming across.
Make sure she was okay. Here comes a couple of subs for Cherokee.
Yeah.
Hampton back in.
Lily Fox, who has a goal today, comes over to number 31, Kylie Evans. Gabrielle Chiodi. Back up top to Bodine. Evans over to Westerby. There's Tori Hampton.
She switches sides with Fox now. Kind of directing the offense there, Hampton was.
Yeah, Westerby coming across into Oh, picked up. Oh, Hampton.
Just didn't have full possession.
On the run play.
Ball will go back over, I believe, to Shawnee. I see the referee pointing in Shawnee's direction. However, it looks like the goalie has it.
There you go. Ashley Vernon let up 7 today so far. Aaron Wicker coming across. Wicker thought she was giving it to Barr. Hits Cherokee player.
They battle for
it. Yeah, they did battle for it. Good battle. Olivia Singer on that fight for the ball. Singer gives it to Hampton. Hampton coming across. Across the 30-yard line, across the 20. Ashley Vernon gives it to Lundberg. Lundberg,
oh, very nice cross. Pass in the center. They got numbers here.
Beckler coming right across in front of the net. Oh, as she backs out. Oh, good play to Misiska. She shoots. She scores. Jenna Misiska.
Yeah, I thought for a minute Beckler might have been a little better off moving off to her right, but they did a nice job there when she moved to her left at Misiska. Uh-huh. Is that how you say it?
Misiska.
Misiska. Yep. And Misiska kind of moved into her right, and nobody went with Misiska, which gave her a little opening, and bang. Nussmann. Very nice. Very, very nice play.
Unselfish play.
Absolutely.
From Molly Beckler. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay.
They get into
Ivy
that 8.
Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
She gets into that 8-meter zone right here. I thought Beckler might be better off going to the right, but she does a nice job. And there's Misiska going to the same spot that Beckler just vacated and gave her a good clean look at the goal, and she finished it off. Now Gabby Bodine back on the draw again.
Draw won by Cherokee.
Not yet.
No. Jinxed them there as
Barr battles for it, and it's going to be Shawnee Ball.
Erica Barr. Barr behind the net. Right for the net. Nice shot. Ooh, nice play. Good chance from Misiska again, right in front of the net. Nice stop by Krug.
And some of our viewers who may not be familiar with lacrosse, you know, when you shoot it wide, whoever the team is that's closest to the end line, when it goes over the end line, is the one that gets the ball. So even if you're the shooting team, if your team is closest to the ball,
Misiska shoots. She scores for her hat trick.
First two goals of the half in the first five, just under 5 minutes, goes to the Renegades, and that's huge. That jumps that back out to that 3-goal lead, the biggest they've had all day.
Yep, let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
This is a nice, real good sidearm shot.
Siska makes
looked
the
like
score.
Looked like she got
10-7.
It between the legs before Krug was able to get the stick down. So first two goals, as I said, of the second half goes to Shawnee, and they're back to their 3-goal lead that they had for long periods of that first half.
Ball picked up. It's gonna be Shawnee ball.
They don't look like an 0-3 team, do they?
No, not right now. Absolutely not.
Just goes to show you how good girls lacrosse is getting here in South Jersey.
Yeah, Misiska looked for another chance. Ball fell out of her stick, but picked up by Barr. Hampton hits her. Yeah, you can't do that.
Yeah, and that'll be Shawnee possession. to Clapperton. I believe she has a goal here in this contest.
She does. Kyra with the ball.
Now here's where Shawnee can be really patient. You know, they got the 3-goal lead. There's no sense in rushing. Let's set up our plays. They've had two beautiful scoring plays in this second half. And here comes another one. There's a nice move.
Oh, she scores! Molly Beckler! She'll score her third. That's a hattie. Molly Beckler makes the score 11-7.
Biggest lead of the game now for the Renegades. Yeah.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. Beckler didn't look like she had a great angle on it, but she did, and that was right through the 5-hole. Right in between the legs of goaltender Gabby Krug. 11-7. Shawnee lead here in Shawnee High School, at Shawnee High School in Medford, New Jersey. Hampton ends up with the ball. This will be one of the first offensive pushes by Cherokee in the second half. As we see Hampton coming in hot. Ball.
And we've got a flag. And this might be in the 8-meter zone, which will give her an 8-meter or a free possession. And it will be. These are tough to stop when you're the goaltender.
Yeah, gotta bear down.
And shoot, there it is.
She Hampton scores.
Hampton converts.
Yep, Hampton scores her second of the day. Score 11-8, Shawnee. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay on the web at Ivy Rehab. Take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay, Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy, on the web at ivyrehab.com. She had the 8-meter shot, took advantage of it, makes it a 3-goal game with 17:53 remaining. That's Molly Beckler. Beckler going to Michigan University, or the University of Michigan. All academically.
Wow, that's impressive. Where are you going, Jimmy Freeze?
At Temple University, Scott. Ah. Media and Communications.
Wow, what a shock.
Erica Barr gives it to Molly Beckler. Barr could have had a nice move. Ball fell out.
Good recovery, though, to scoop it back up before Cherokee got it.
Masiska, who has 3 today.
2 in this half.
Masiska coming around, ball falls out. Looks like we're gonna have a call.
Don't think she was in the 8-meter.
That looks like she was.
Yeah, you're right. Couldn't tell from our vantage point here.
Comes a shot. That'll be off, yeah, to the right of the goaltender.
Yeah, she tried to go short side low, and Krug made a nice little save there to keep it away, but the ball goes over the end line. Shawnee closest to it, so they'll maintain possession.
Erica Barr.
Again, the Renegades set up their offense.
Masiska Barr. and Beckler. We've seen a lot out of for Shawnee. A lot of good work from those three. All goals from those three. Siska coming across, loses the ball again. Probably another penalty. It is.
It's probably going to result in another 8 meter. It is. Last time she went short side. Let's see if she goes far side this time.
Oh, and she goes
same short side, but with a lot more power.
Yes, a lot more power. Masiska scores her fourth of the day.
And that's three in this half alone. I think she only had one at the half. So she's certainly kind of, let's use the old expression, kind of putting the team on her back here in the second half.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Here she is on the 8 meter, makes a nice move in and goes low, and gets it right by her. Almost the same spot as she tried to get the previous goal. Krug was able to, or the previous 8 meter, Krug was able to make that save originally on the first one, but not this time. A lot more steam, if you will, on that one.
So far in this half, Shawnee scored 4 goals, Cherokee 1.
Cherokee able to pick up the loose ground ball after the draw.
Substitutions in for Cherokee. Hampton back in. Mary Carroll back in. Coming across, that's Kylie Evans.
She looked like she wanted to drop it back off the over her shoulder, but there was nobody there for Cherokee, and Shawnee had it nicely defended.
Westerby, just under 14
and a half now to go in the game.
Right in front of the net, that's Lily Fox.
Oh, save.
Yeah, that was Bodine who shot. That was a foot save.
And we've got a foul, but I'm not sure who they're calling it on here.
That was a kick save from Vernon.
And the foul is going to be on Shawnee, so it'll give an 8 meter to number 33.
Gabrielle Chiodi.
Thank you.
Yep.
And another huge save by Ashley Vernon.
We're going to take a quick moment here to thank the cast, or, and the cast and crew, pretty much, of today's game on LDTV with Sean Erb, Matt Mathis, Owen Volkerich, Josh Gladstone, and Liam Keller, Talon Loriello, Abigail Erb, Fabiana Ferraglio, Austin Tuchecki, and our sideline reporter, Bonnie Brager, giving it to us good. And your announcers here, Scott Glossner and Jimmy Freeze, thank you for joining us on LDTV Sports as we see Grace Kyra come around the offensive zone for Shawnee.
Huge save there by Ashley Vernon on that last 8 meter.
Bar up top.
Looks like a little more urgency from the Chiefs defense as we approach the halfway mark of half number two. Renegades maintaining a 4-goal lead. Nice pass.
Oh! Shot goes awry. That's what it is. Awry. Up top across above the crossbar.
It's a good try though by Molly Beckler. She had that upper corner and she went for it and just shot it a little bit high.
Beckler back up top. Beckler, nice move.
Cut off, but it looks like we've got a check. And might this result in an 8 meter? Because I think she was right there. And it will for Beckler. It'll be a tough play here for Krug.
Beckler.
Oh, nice spin it outside. Yeah. Nice job by Beckler. She didn't have a good shooting angle from that angle, from where she was on the wing.
Misiska, nice play to Krug.
Is that a foul? But it's going to be a goal. We had it. We had a foul that would have been called if the goal had not been resulted. But what a shot!
Oh
what
my
a
gosh!
Spin shot. She spun and come out of her spin and just rifled it into the upper corner.
Grace Kyra, pretty much as she was falling.
That might be the sweetest goal we've seen today.
Yes, definitely.
And now a five-goal Renegade lead.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
And we're back. Okay, cool. After that goal scored by Grace Kyra. Fun fact about Grace Kyra, dating the Mr. Alpaca, Timmy O'Hanlon, who played for Shawnee, face-off man for the lacrosse team. Both great lacrosse players. As we see Shawnee back in the offensive zone. Up top, Molly Beckler with the ball. Gives it to Jenna Misiska. Masiska's got the ball. She's got four today. Misiska driving in. She's stopped by Krug. Erica Barr. Barr coming in, she'll back out. Tori Hampton coming across.
Loose again.
Yep, picked up by.
We've got a whistle, and they're going to give possession to either Cherokee or Shawnee. Shawnee.
Yeah, that's number eight, Jenna Misiska. Misiska coming across. Oh, nice spin move.
Nicely defended, though. I believe that might have been Lily Fox on the defense there.
That was. Nice work.
Because that was a nice spin move there, but Lily Fox stayed right with her. And I give Misiska credit for not trying to force a shot there.
Barr gives it back to Misiska, gives it back to Barr, and Beckler's got it. There's Barr. So Scott, what they want to do is pretty much conservatively keep the foot or keep the pedal to the metal.
Yes.
Right? You do not want to push it too hard and then Cherokee gets on a fast break and then they just score a couple here and there. They want to keep the pressure, but keep the ball, be careful with it, pass it carefully. So to the right of the net. Barr gives it to Misiska. Beckler coming across, coming to the net.
Oh, what a nice save play by Krug.
Yeah, shot that, and Krug with a nice stick save. Couple girls coming out here for Cherokee. Need some time. Whistle will result in Cherokee ball. Cherokee ball coming across. We haven't seen the ball down this end very much this half, Scott.
No, we have not. You're absolutely right, Jimmy. They only have, one goal still in this whole half?
Yep.
And we're 17 and a half minutes in.
Westerby. Over to Mary Carroll. Right for the net. Nice leg
great
save. Leg save from Ashley Vernon. Erica Barr to Aaron Wicker. Danielle Lorenz in for the Renegades. Mom's a teacher here, Miss Lorenz, Mrs. Lorenz. Teaches American women, foreign affairs, world cultures, U.S. history, whatever you need.
Nice pass.
Or gives it to Kyra's Kyra right into the
stick. Oh, save again. That was a big save.
Good save by Krug. Cherokee coming across. Looks to be Devin Fitzpatrick with the ball. It is. Mary Carroll with the ball. Carroll goes to Fox. Hampton shoots right into the stick of Ashley Vernon. Right into the netting there. Kira Lundberg. Jenna Masiska could not grasp it. Grace Kyra, nice play, getting the ball. Kicks it back to Lundberg. There's Emma Luling. She's got two today.
That must be a timeout.
And it is. With 4:24 remaining in today's game.
And Jimmy, we were right. You do leave the sticks there so that they maintain the same positions. I was talking to one of the coaches before, one of the assistant coaches. Before the timeout, you are to go back to the same spots where you were before.
LDTV Sports Productions are available online at youtube.com/LenapeeDistrictTV and for purchase at www.lrhsd.org/LDTV copies. Let's go, Renegades! And our next game here is the varsity girls softball. That's going to be Shawnee hosting the Paul VI, the Eagles. And again, you can check out the full schedule on www.lrhsd.org/LDTV.
Of course, we'll have a little break from LDTV broadcasting here for the next week and a half or so because we've got spring break coming up for the Lenape Regional High School District. So we wish everybody a nice break away from school, both faculty and administration and students. Hope they enjoy themselves and get a little rest and relaxation and come back to finish out the last less than 2 months of the school year when we return. for some of you, less than 2 months to your high school, end of your high school career.
Yes, it is. .424, Scott, what does Cherokee do to get back into the game? Five goals, they need five.
Well, you can score goals in bunches. What they have to do is kind of create turnovers, because if Shawnee plays smart the rest of the way, they will be able to take some time off the clock in each and every position. A possession, I mean.
Right.
So we'll see what happens. But it's a long road to hoe when you've only scored one goal in the first, what, almost 21 minutes, 20 and a half minutes? So to pump in five and not give up any in the last four and a half, that's a tall order.
Okay, Shawnee ball, Molly Beckler coming in.
And as you can see, they're trying to ramp up the defense and get a little more aggressive, but that's gonna result in, you know, maybe a whistle or two here, and as it did just right here.
Erica Barr gives it to Masiska.
Now they're trying to see how they spread the offense out. They're much, much wider than they had been before. And they're going to try to make Cherokee chase. And what can happen is, something like that, or what can happen is a defender will break loose. I mean, offensive player will break loose because you've got the defense running around and give you a golden scoring opportunity.
Grace Kyra comes in, takes a tumble. Bar goes to Kyra. Kyra's got it. Kyra getting pressured.
You know, we came back from this timeout with 4.5 minutes to go, and now there's under 2.5, and Shawnee still has possession.
Yep.
And doing a very nice job. It's almost like, oh, what a great pass.
Emma Luling scores! Emma Luling notches her third for the hat trick. With 2:18 remaining in the game. Take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. Shot score. Emma Luling gets her third of the day. Whistle called. Approaching our last 2 minutes here at Shawnee High School.
Big second half for the Renegades, 6-1.
Cherokee coming across. Devin Fitzpatrick comes across. Fitzpatrick gives it to Fox. Torrey Hampton.
That'll be a little push there.
Yeah. That'll be Kelsey Martin on that. Is that going to result in an 8-meter there, Scott?
Yes, right on the edge of it.
Hampton shot and
scores. Just deflected in. She got
right off the
Vernon
stick.
Got some of it, but not all of it.
Torrey Hampton gets her hat trick. 3 goals today for the junior. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. Ball picked up by Cherokee. Grace Kyra fighting for it. Torrey Hampton coming across with the ball. Shoots. Nice save there from Vernon. Aaron Wicker with the ball. Aaron Wicker across. Gives it to Lundberg. Five seconds remaining here at Shawnee High School. With our score 14-9, the Renegades. Shawnee will get their first win of the season, and they will award Cherokee their first loss of the season. Scott, what does this do for Shawnee?
Well, it gives them momentum going into their
next two games,
and they've got two really, really tough games. So as well as they've played today, the level of competition, not that Cherokee's not a very stout team, is going to be ratcheted up a couple notches when you talk about Mountain Lakes and Moorestown. But it does, you know, how much better will they feel with that first win under their belt that they know that the confidence level that was maybe a little lower than it should have been for a Shawnee team is going to be rising a little bit after this big, huge victory this afternoon here at Shawnee High School.
And that will be the end of today's game with Shawnee getting their first W of the season at home. Score 14-9. The Shawnee Renegades will notch their record to 1-3, and Cherokee will be 3-1. Great, terrific jobs done by Jenna Masiska. In net by Ashley Vernon. And we will be back here at Shawnee High School for the play and player of the game.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward. Please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
At Shawnee High School, back here at Shawnee High School, after that terrific game by the Renegades, winning that on a score. It's now time to take a look at the Allstate Good Hands Play of the Game, sponsored by Michael McDyer, CLTC, at 609-654-1426, or Michael McDyer at allstate.com. Allstate, you're in good hands. It's going to be the play by Molly Beckler. Molly Beckler comes across, crosses the net.
This is right the one in. Where she came out from behind the goal and made a nice move. The defender kind of looked back at the goaltender to see if she was in the right position, and Beckler sliced right on through and banged it home for the goal.
Yes, she did. Impressive job by Molly Beckler. Leads the team to with three goals. Jenna Masiska had four goals. Molly Beckler had three. Emma Luling had three. Terrific job. On the Cherokee side, Gab Bodine had four. Tori Hampton had three. Gabby Krug did a nice job in net, you know, let up those goals, but she had some pretty big stops to help it to not get too out of control. It's now time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game at 1-800-896-RECON or on the web at www.reconstructiveortho.com. Let's send it over to Bonnie Brager, standing by for the report.
Thanks, guys. So I'm here with Jenna, and she had a great game. How did you prepare for today's game?
Today as a team, we really wanted to work together. We tried to fix and work on our fast break defense and working together on attack.
Awesome. And what was going through your head as you were playing today?
I was trying to make smart decisions, looking for what was best for the team, and trying to pull out a win today.
Awesome. And what are the plans for the rest of the season for you and the team?
Me and the team really want to keep the run going and keep the momentum going and keep up the great play.
Awesome. Thanks so much and congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that'll do it for us here on LDTV. For Scott Glossner, and that's our final score here, 14-9, Shawnee Renegades. And for Scott Glossner and Jimmy Freeze, thank you very much and have a good night.
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
District has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.